Captain Falcon.
And here we go. Those are semis. Pancakes versus Spartacus. Everyone's favorite mall cop. They're both wearing kind of similar jackets now that I look at it. Like, they've got those, like, I don't know what you call them. Lapels, those kind of pentagon-shaped things on their coat pockets in the front. Both the dark color, you know. Looks like we could have picked them up off the street. I'm joking. These guys are great. Going to Battlefield for game one. Start right off. Oh, this is interesting. Looks like Henke is quite content to sit on the platform if he doesn't feel threatened. Alright, no room to get the running combo with the down throw, so just forward throws. I don't know if that does more damage or not. Yeah, he's just like going to this platform. Very interesting. Oh, wow. The fusion not quite getting Falcon out of his unfortunate tech roll. It's better in BM than it is in melee. Oh, wow. Actually gets him, and yeah. Oh, there's no... They didn't have stocks on. Okay, yeah. So that's... Sparty with the next level strats. Turning it on infinite time so that he can download the first stock of patterns from his opponents. What a grind board. That's why his tail is green. It's all that sewage that he's ingested. But Pancakes is also really green, so... anyway... So a very different style from what we saw with BJ versus Spartacus, where he was all about, you know, really actively spacing nairs, attempting to catch Sparty, whereas Pancake. So an unintended consequence of this, like, this joke name that I've put up is that they both start with a P, and so when I go to the top of the screen to remind myself of which player is which, they both start with a P, and sometimes I want to say Paul Spartacus when I mean Pancakes. So, suboptimal strategy coming out from Flashing Fire, with the commentator setup. Up air to knee looking pretty optimal though. Yeah, that's not gonna... That will not work. Oh, two stomps. Two stomps this time. Bam! Yeah, okay, Pancakes, he's a man with a plan. He is... He's going to make sweet love to those platforms, man. It's like, he just does not want to be down there. And I mean, it's working. Like, he's getting percent as Sparty attempts to do, like, his teleport shenanigans. Okay, gentlemen, the good DI from Sparty not to get just straight up comboed into me. Yeah, the forward smash not looking like a great option when all Pancakes wants to do is go to the top platform. Okay, now that Sparty's a kill percent, he's just kind of throwing out knees. Really making Sparty regret going to Battlefield here. This is like a level of commitment to a game plan that I have not seen in this state in like forever. I can't recall the last time a player was this dedicated to this kind of strategy. But Pancakes, you know, making money off of it. Yeah, and if Sparty goes up to intercept, Falcon can get back down to the ground quicker. Down throw a knee. Okay, starts getting the shadow ball going on. Missed L cancel. Missed edge guard. That's really unfortunate. There are some things like that where, like, the path that the opponent has to take is very clear, and Sparty kind of messes it up with his, like, hover timing with backers. Oh, Pancake's coming down to fight. And suddenly, the pace of the match has increased a lot. Goes back to the top platform. He's had it up there. Oh, that up air almost came out. If he had scooped him up with that up air, that definitely would have been an E-kill. Four stock there. Oh, this could be it. No? Down throw. Delayed knee, but 4 stock complete. Goodness gracious. Yeah, that worked very well. Okay, so I imagine Sparty will... he's ruining the platforms in the equation here. FD was left open. Beaches up throw combos. Do work fairly well on Falcon at low percent. Oh. Yeah, that's greedy. But the reverse... Already going for a few reads. It looks like the neutral game that Pancakes is playing is like, he's not really keeping pace, you know? He's trying to throw out some reads. Pancakes is kind of letting him make the first mistake. Although, that should do it, yeah. Catches the jump with the back air and suddenly really even matched. The fate of a fast follower against Mewtwo's Gurr. Oh, nice mix up. Landing the nair super early. Crossing up Sparty. Pancakes is not getting shield grab. He is having none of that. Down throw up our knee. Classic. I don't know if Sparty can figure out a DI to get out of that, because like he has the hover options, but Mewtwo just kind of seems to get really destroyed by Falcon's combo game. And he's kind of in position for the tech chase, but Pancakes continues to be relentless. Throwing out some shadow balls. When you have the room to do that, it's not a terrible idea. Just not let Falcon be comfortable moving around you. Oh, 3-2. Another. And he double jumped. All right. Unfortunate, but will it matter? Okay, Sparty doing a little bit of his signature teleport tricksies. And now he's got some percent. Oh, sick stuff. He has an opportunity. Oh, he misses the grab. Big drop. Okay. Pancakes recognizing the DI is a little hazardous to go for the knee there. Oh, but he just keeps dash dancing. He keeps grabbing, and he keeps killing him. Pancakes firmly in the driver's seat. Fitting for what Captain Falcon liked to do for his chosen profession. Yeah, this is looking a bit like a drive-by. Must say. Sparty's had a few opportunities. He's gotten some grabs. He got that one good edge guard that he spotted. He really needs to be able to set himself up for those more often. Because those are kills at like 60 or less, you know? We got the most voluminous music in the whole music pack, maybe, on the Smash build. Three. I'll choose his up air again. Sparty getting in with the nair, but words are hard sometimes. Oh, he actually gets shield grab. That's unusual. Yeah, going for a little bit of a desperation loop tool. Get pieces, get up attack. Very, very good. Okay. After like three sour spot knees, Pancakes will find the one that makes Paul Blarticus regret. Whoa, okay. Mewtwo sliding so far that he actually broke out of the grab. Whew. Okay, it's... Yeah, it's just looking like Pancakes. Look at that! He reads the teleport, catches all of Sparty's options. This is just looking like pretty hard outclassing right now. Yeah. He's got mix-ups, he's got the cross-ups, he's got the shield pressure. He moonwalked there, I don't know if you guys noticed it. Down throw. Oh, actually breaks out that time. Sparty's showing signs of life. Yep, alright. Not out of it just yet. Oh, I'm not sure what that was supposed to be. But he makes the best out of it, and I guess that doesn't quite work. Maybe he needed up air. Whatever the case, Pancakes did jump out of that up to a fair attempt. Oh, going for everything. Sparty does not grab ledge. think he buffered hover and tried to forward air, is what happened. So we only had his teleport left. Oh, that could cost him. Nope. He's too big, too floaty. Spartacus not finding ledge. Back throw? Yeah, it hasn't worked before. I'm not sure why it would now. And, yeah, no resources. A convincing victory. This pancake just kind of rolls over Spartacus. To advance to loser semis. Whew. All right. So as much as I know that like Falcon already does well in that matchup, it looks like Sparty has a ways to go there in terms of figuring out what the heck he's supposed to do in the neutral game.